So good morning, everyone.
大家早.
It's always good to see everyone here on a communion Sunday.
能够在圣餐的主日看到大家真的是非常高兴.
You know, let's start with a prayer.
我们一起来祷告.
Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be here.
主，我们感谢你，让我们能够来敬拜你.
You know, we get to come to worship you, the Creator of heaven and earth.
我们能够来敬拜你这位创造天地万物的主宰.
You know, I talked to a lot of people this weekend. And there are so many issues of life that we go through, but right now, in this hour, Lord, in this time, will you just help us to just put down everything that's worrying us and lay them down at your feet?
主啊，在这个礼拜的期间，曾经跟好几位弟兄姐妹一起来，有会面，有相谈的一些时间。 每个人心中都有很多的困难跟很多很多的挑战，主啊，帮助我们在这个此时此刻，让我们把这些世上的忧虑都放在你的脚前，让我们能够来专心的聆听你的话语。Lord,
we need you.
主啊，我们需要你。Will
you just bless your people and allow your Holy Spirit to just speak to us right now?
主啊，此刻就让圣灵亲自对我们的说话祝福我们。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。Amen. Amen.
You know, it's so good to see you guys here this morning. And we continue in the Gospel of Luke at the latter portion of Luke chapter 4.
真的很高兴在主日看到弟兄姐妹。那我们来到路加福音第四章的最下半的部分。You
know, Jesus was teaching and people were listening and following Jesus.
耶稣基督在做教导，然后人们都专心的来聆听，然后遵照他的心意而行。The
news about Jesus' teaching spread throughout the whole region of Galilee.
耶稣基督的教导已经传遍了整个加利利，大家都晓得。A
crowds of people were just gathered, and they were healed by Jesus.
一大堆的人追随了主耶稣基督，然后很多生病人也得到医治。You
know, Dr. Luke, with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, was telling us in this section that he wants us to know that there's power and authority in Jesus and in his word.
我们知道路加福音的作者路加医生，他来告诉我们，耶稣基督的话语是带有权柄的，是多么有的能力。
And Dr. Luke also gave us a glimpse of what happened in the day of Jesus' life.
按照路加福音的路加医生的记载，他们看到耶稣基督他一整天到底在做什么。So
people sometimes ask the pastor, you know, what do you do in your week? What do you do in a day?
有时候人们会问牧师，牧师啊，在这个礼拜当中你到底做什么？你一天里面到底做了什么事情？So
people who ask this question usually think that pastors only work one day out of the week and nothing to do the other 6 days.
会问这个问题的人，他们会许说啊，牧师，你可能一个礼拜只工作一天吧。
So some of my friends who are pastors, when they hear this question, they would just smile.
牧师也有些牧师的朋友啊，他们做牧师，他们听到这个问题的时候，就发出会心的微笑。
And these friends of mine, they decided to just tell the truth and just say what happened throughout their day, and they give this list.
牧师的牧师朋友就说，那我就坦诚以告嘛，我就把我这一整天里面到底做了是什么事情，一长串来讲出来。
And then they would smile and they said, that's just one day. Would you like to hear the rest of the 6 days?
然后他们说，哎，你看，这就是我一天做的事情，其他六天你要听吗？
So the people who ask these questions usually would have their mouth open and said, you know, I thought you just work on Sundays and you just, you know, rehash what you taught before and then teach it again, like school teachers.
这些听到牧师讲到说，一整天工作这么多，他们这些问问题的人说，我以为你礼拜天只工作那一个小时，然后把一些过去旧有的讲到资料再重新整理出来再讲一次而已，不是吗？
And they actually would say that I didn't know pastor have to go through all that.
他们说，哎，我真的不晓得牧师要经历这么多的事情哎。
So on a side note, if you are thinking or planning to be in pastoral ministry, you know, if you're planning to shepherd a church, you better find out if you're called by God to do that.
顺带一提的是，如果你有心从事这个牧养的工作，你想要牧养一个教会，你最好确定你的呼召是来自于神哦。
Because if you're not called by God to do that, I will tell you, and most pastors would tell you, that you'll be very miserable and you'll be very burned out quickly because you're doing something that God did not call you to do.
如果上帝没有呼召你做这个牧者的工作的话，你最要小心一点，因为你很快就会精疲力竭，然后就枯干了。
And there's no peace, and there'll be no contentment in your life.
而且你的人生当中也不会有平安跟满足哦。
But if you're called by God, and even, you know, it doesn't mean that everything will be smooth in life, but it does mean that when things are not smooth,and you still have this peace in your heart and contentment in your heart, you're doing what God wants you to do.
如果你被神呼召去做神要你做的事情，即使在面对不顺遂、不平静的时候，你依然心中保有那个平安跟满足的话，我要恭喜你，那就是神对你的呼召。
And the work you do will be light; you will not be heavy.
因为你所做的是与上帝同工，那个轭是轻省的。
When you have that peace of God and the contentment of God in your life, even when things are going wrong, you're doing exactly what God wants you to do.
在这样的被呼召的过程里面，即使你碰到不顺遂，但是你依然保有心中保有那个满足跟平安的话，就是神呼召你做的。
So Jesus, you know, people may ask, what do you do throughout your day?
所以人们会问耶稣，耶稣啊，你一整天到底在做什么？
Yeah, while you're on earth, what did you do?
你已经降临到这个世间，那你到底都做什么事呢？
We just read that Jesus was at the Capernaum synagogue and he was teaching on the Sabbath.
我们刚刚读到的经文，耶稣基督来到加百农的犹太会堂，然后他在安息日做教导。
By the way, I shared this before. Capernaum synagogue was next to Peter's house, and Susan and I were married in Capernaum, so we can show that picture. That's where we were married at. That's Capernaum.
加百农会堂，彼得他的家就在加百农犹太会堂的旁边。那牧师跟师母就是在加百农的这个犹太会堂结婚的。
You know, after this pandemic settles down, I would recommend, I highly encourage you to visit Israel.And walk where Jesus walked.
如果你有兴趣，那如果在疫情比较舒缓，那有机会出国的话，牧师非常建议有机会可以到以色列这个加百农这个会堂。
So Jesus taught in that synagogue, and remember what happened, Luke 4:32. They were amazed at his teaching because his words had authority.
耶稣就是在加百农的这个犹太会堂教导，然后路加福音4:23记载，他们很稀奇耶稣的教训，因为耶稣的话里有权柄。
You know, the people in that synagogue, they were amazed and astonished.
在犹太这个加百农的会堂里面，您听到耶稣的教导时，他们非常的惊讶。
They usually do not hear teaching with authority.And with power.
因为他们每个主日、每个安息日所听到的这些教训，并没有带有权柄能力。
So when Jesus taught, compared to what they heard before, they were just going, "Whoa!"
所以耶稣的教导，他们聆听的时候，跟以前的这些教导比较起来的时候，他们都非常的惊讶。
During that time, the teachers of that time, the scribes and the rabbis, they would usually teach about legalism.Do this and not do that.
当时的这些犹太的法利赛人跟这些律法教师，他们在做教导的时候，都是根据犹太主义，然后都是非常一成不变的。
They taught to follow the law. They taught what other rabbis had said or researched.
他们说你要照着律法要这样子做，不可以那样做。然后他们都遵照以前律法教师的传统遗留下来的一成不变的教导。
It's usually dry. It was boring.And there's actually no joy and no application for daily life because they couldn't do what they taught.
这些聆听律法主义教导人是非常非常枯燥单调的，而且呢，这些教导包括教导的人他自己都没有办到。
The usual teaching had no power and no authority.
这些教导一成不变的教导没有任何的权柄跟
能力。It was a ritual they go through.Each week.
这是他们每个安息日就照着这样去做。
It's like the rabbis used old oatmeal that was cooked a while back ago, and they would reheat it up and then use that old oatmeal flavorless and use it as a teaching for this week and week after week.
这些律法的教师就好像把一个燕麦粥已经过去已经煮了一段时间吃剩下来，然后再把它加热，然后再重新端给这些会众吃。
It did not taste good.
我想这些滋味不太好。
But when Jesus spoke, people were listening intently, and his teaching was scripturally true and applicable for all seasons of life.
可是当耶稣教导的时候，人们却是非常非常的专注，因为他根据的是圣经里面的真理。
When Jesus taught, people paid attention, and they never stayed neutral.
而且耶稣教导的时候，人们非常专注的聆听，而且这些都是可以实际运用的。然后你在聆听的时候，你的立场就无法保持中立。
This is why we emphasize the Word of God here at Calvary.
所以我们在教会非常注重神话语的教导。
When God's voice is heard through His Word, His Holy Spirit is working in our hearts to receive His Word, and it transforms us from the inside.
当上帝的声音透过他的话语展现出来的时候，就会改变我们内在的生命，然后展现出来。
And then we are more and more like him, the way he created us to be, and more like Jesus.
透过他话语转变我们的生命，我们就越来越像他，越来越像主耶稣基督。
Jesus' word, the word of God, has power and authority.
耶稣所教导的是带有能力跟权柄的。
This is why every time I preach, I put the Word of God on this pulpit in front of me. And this is why I quote the Word of God in my message.
所以牧师当他在做主日讲道的时候，就把圣经摆在讲台上面，根据上帝的话语来教导。
If you're here on Wednesday night, I usually just sit over here and just with the Bible, we go over the Bible verse by verse.And chapter by chapter.
如果你有机会参加礼拜三晚上的查经聚会，就会看到牧师摆张椅子坐在上面，然后手里拿着一本圣经，照着逐章逐节的方式来分享。
Why do we do that?
为什么要这样子做呢？
Because God's word is living, it's powerful, and when we hear it, when we meditate on it, it actually heals us, it actually comforts us, it gives us peace, and gives us guidance.For how to live life.
因为上帝的话语活泼大有能力，当我们聆听的时候，它就改变我们的生命，医治我们的生命，然后使我们可以在世上活出它的见证来。
This is why Bible studies, prayer meetings, fellowship, where the Bible is central, it's so important in one's spiritual life here on earth.
所以在各项的聚会，包括祷告的聚会、查经的聚会，圣经是一定在中间，因为圣经才是最主要的。
Psalm 119, 130. The unfolding of your words gives light. It gives understanding to the simple.
诗篇119篇130节，你的言语一解开，就发出亮光，使愚人通达。
Susan and I went to see Spider-Man this past week, and when I was a kid, I loved Marvel Comics.
他牧师跟师母这礼拜去看那个蜘蛛人，当牧师小时候，他非常喜欢这个漫威的动画。
See, Spider-Man gets this.Tingly, you know, it's a spidey sense when dangers come.
你知道蜘蛛人他非常非常的敏感，一有危险发生的时候，他就知道。
And I understand there are different teaching styles for pastors throughout this world.
牧师要跟大家分享，全世界有很多种不同的牧师，他有各种不同的教导
方式。But I get this little tingly spidey sense that something is not right when the teacher just roams around the stage and do not use the Bible or use very little Bible but uses bestsellers, Christian bestsellers, uses human intellectualism as scripture.
牧师对于有些牧师他在讲台上面在那边跑来跑去，然后只是用一点点的圣经的话语教导，主要是参考这些圣经的那个这些著作的畅销书来引述的话，牧师觉得有点不安。
I actually was told a couple of days ago that a lot of churches here locally, they don't want to use Bible for their studies, they use other things for their studies.
牧师最近听说，这附近的教会有些他们聚会的时候，他们不再用圣经作为主要的这些依据，而是用其他的材料。
So the danger is this: that people would come and they would hear a person and wants to be entertained and to be pumped up instead of coming to church, hearing the living word of God, to worship the living God, to be healed and transformed on the inside by Jesus' word, because we are sinners in need of healing, in need of saving.
所以这个危险性在于，当人们来到教会的时候，他们听到了只是这个人的个人的经验、个人的学识的分享，然后希望大家得到打气而已，而不是把上帝的话语、这个会活泼的生命的话语展现给大家，让大家能够来接纳。
So pastors should always point to Jesus and His Word, and never to themselves.
所以一个牧者在讲道的时候，一定要把观众的注意力集中在耶稣以及他的话语、圣经的话语上面。
I have seen too many pastors pressured into this awful position of being an entertainer, and the pressure of having to come up with entertainment each week to appease their elder boards, to appease the audience, because they demand entertainment, and that is just so sad.
牧师已经看到太多太多的例子，有些牧者受到这些可能长职或是会友的压力，只是要来取悦、来娱乐他的会众而已。
When pastors come to talk to me about their real life experience and the pressure to appease, I listen, I hurt, I cry, and I pray for them.
当这些牧者来跟牧师在做协谈、来做分享的时候，牧师就感受到他们的压力，也为他们祷告，一起互相的流泪，然后希望他们能够再次从神那里重新得力。
When a church's foundation is based on Scripture, and when the pastor is taken away to meet the Lord Himself in heaven or somewhere else, it's okay, because the foundation of the church is based on the Word of God, not on a person.
当一个教会，它的基础是建立在上帝的话语的时候，即使这个牧者他被接到天家与主同在，这个教会的根基依然是坚实的。
The foundation is not based on any human being; it is only based on King Jesus and King Jesus' Word.
教会的基础是建立在耶稣以及他的话语身上，不是建立在个人身上。
You see, Jesus' word is important.
耶稣的话语，圣经的话语是非常重要的。
At the Mount of Transfiguration, God the Father said, Matthew 17:5, while he was still speaking, a bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my Son, whom I love; with him I am well pleased. Listen to him."
当耶稣登山变相的时候，记载在马太福音17:5，说话之间，忽然有一朵光明的云彩遮盖他们，且有声音从云彩里出来说：“这是我的爱子，我所喜悦的，你们要听他。”God
the Father said, "Listen to Jesus."
天父上帝说：“你们要听我的爱子耶稣所讲的。”Are
you? Are we listening to Jesus on a regular basis?
你我有非常非常规律正当每天来聆听耶稣的话语吗？
It's when we open up His Word, that's when He meets with us.
当我们打开圣经阅读的时候，耶稣就在对我们说话。
When we truly hear the Word of Jesus, it'll change us.
当我们真实的听到主耶稣基督的话语，会改变我们的生命。
When Jesus met those sad people at the road to Emmaus, after his resurrection, he talked with them, had a meal with them, and they were changed from sadness to joy.
路加福音记载，当耶稣被钉十字架，有两个门徒走在以马忤斯的路上，他们心里非常非常的哀伤。但是耶稣与他们同行，用上帝的话语再次的激励鼓励他们。
Luke 24:32, they asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?"
路加福音24:32，这两个门徒彼此说，在路上耶稣和我们说话，给我们讲解圣经的时候，我们的心岂不是火热的吗？
So what does Jesus do during his day?
所以耶稣一整天到底在干嘛？
He taught the word of God.
他教导上帝的话语。
As Jesus was teaching, there was an interruption.
当耶稣在做教导的时候，忽然被打断了。
A demon-possessed man who said, "Leave, let us alone. We know who you are, Jesus of Nazareth, the Holy One of God. Did you come to destroy us?"
当耶稣在做教导的时候，忽然有一个被鬼附身的说，耶稣基督，你这位神的圣者，你要来消灭我们吗？
So the people there must have been shocked. I mean, we're at the synagogue, at church. I mean, who let this crazy guy in?
所以在这个加百农会堂的这些会众非常非常的惊讶，哎，到底是谁让这个人进来的
？Luke 4:35-37. Be quiet, Jesus said sternly. Come out of him. Then the demon threw the man down before them all, and came out without injuring him. All the people were amazed and said to each other.What words these are. With authority and power, he gives order to impure spirits, and they come out. And the news about him spread throughout the surrounding area.
路加福音四章三五到三十七节，耶稣责备他说，不要作声，从这人身上出来吧。鬼把那人摔倒在众人中间就出来了，却没有害他。众人都惊讶，彼此对问说，这是什么道理呢？因为他用权柄能力吩咐污鬼，污鬼就出来了。于是耶稣的名声传遍了周围地方。
Jesus did not engage in small talk with this man, the demon-possessed man, but he delivered him.
耶稣并没有跟这个污鬼做什么寒暄 的说话，而是直接吩咐污鬼从这个人身上出来。
Jesus wants to free people, you and me, from enslaved to sin.
耶稣基督希望我们能够从罪恶的捆绑当中释放出来。
He gave two short commands, be quiet and come out of him.
耶稣发出了两个简单的命令，不要作声，从这个人身上出来。
The demons, they knew when the Son of God says something, commands something, they obey.
这些污鬼听到说，上帝的儿子发出命令了，我们一定要遵从啊。
The demon came out and did not hurt the man anymore.
这个污鬼就从这个人身上出来，而且没有再作乱。
The word of God heals, it gives liberty and gives freedom from sin.
上帝的话语带有能力，他让这个人重新得到自由跟释放。
The people there were watching and all of this, and they were just amazed at Jesus' teaching.
当众这些会众都听到耶稣的教导，然后看到这样的情，都非常非常的惊讶。
This guy's word, they're looking at Jesus and he has power, he has authority, and everyone wanted to see, to hear him, and everything that Jesus did throughout his day showed who he is and why he came.
耶稣基督的话语带有权柄跟能力，让人们都非常非常的惊讶，定睛在耶稣身上，想知道耶稣这一整天到底做了什么事情。
But even though they saw all this, they're still wondering, who is this guy and how could he do all of this?
他们看到耶稣基督所做的这些事情，但他们心中还是带着疑问，他是谁啊？他怎么能够做这些事情呢？
But it's interesting that the demons knew.Who Jesus was.
但是非常有趣的，这些污鬼他们知道耶稣是谁啊。
In fact, the Bible tells us that the demons not only knew who Jesus was, but they feared him and they shuddered.
他们这些污鬼不但知道耶稣基督真实的身份，而且非常畏惧他，听从他的命令。
The demons knew their Bible.
这些污鬼还知道圣经的教导。
They understood the doctrine of the Trinity, that Jesus was the Son of God and the Holy One of God.
这些污鬼还知道三一神的真理，知道耶稣是其中的第二位神。
They understood that their end will not be good, but the demons want to take as many people with them to hell as possible.
这些污鬼知道他自己的结局一定是非常非常的悲惨的，但是在这之前，他们希望把更多人带到那个悲惨的结局。
So what does Jesus do throughout his day?
所以耶稣基督一整天到底在做什么？
He cast out demons and gives freedom to people from sin.
他赶出污鬼，让人们能够重新得到自由。
So what happened next?
接下来发生什么事呢？
Luke 4:38-39. Jesus left the synagogue and went to the home of Simon. Now Simon's mother-in-law was suffering from a high fever, and they asked Jesus to help her. Verse 39. So he bent over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up at once and began to wait on them.
路加福音4章38到39节，耶稣出了会堂，进了西门的家。西门的岳母害热病甚重，有人为他求耶稣，耶稣就站在他旁边，斥责那热病，热就退了。他立刻起来服侍他们。
So this was like after church, you know, people are hungry. You know, after the synagogue, they want to get something to eat. And Peter probably said, "Hey, my house is just next door. Come on over."
好像说啊，大家在那个加百农犹太会堂聚会结束了啊，肚子饿了，然后想说，那我们能够去哪里有东西吃呢？彼得就说，哎，来我家吧，我家就在旁边。
You know, it's just like, you know.Peter's just saying that, you know, my mother-in-law's over there, and she's a great host, a great cook. Come on over.
西门彼得可能会说，哎，我的岳母她非常会力啊，很会料理哦。我们一起来吃吧。
So the Bible says this is Peter's wife's mother. Peter was married. So just to let some of you know.
圣经告诉我们这是彼得的岳母嘛，所以我们知道彼得他是已婚的哈。
But what he did not know.Was that his mother-in-law, as Dr. Luke, physician Luke described it, had a high fever that day.
但是西门彼得不晓得他的岳母害着热病，但我们晓得路加福音的作者路加医生，他知道彼得的岳母害热病，发高烧。
You know, before COVID, we all understood, we all experienced what regular flus are like.
在这个疫情之前，我们都知道普通的感冒到底是怎么回事。
You know, with normal flus, we would take medicine, we get some rest, we drink some water, but we could still function at home.
知道我们如果得了感冒的话，我们就多喝水，然后吃药，但是我们还能够正常的工作生活，不是吗？
And we may be just uncomfortable.
或许只是一些不舒服而已。
But this week at Beto Costco's, I jumped.When someone just sneezed next to me.
但是这礼拜牧师在这个北投的好事多的时候，当有人在旁边打喷嚏的时候，牧师吓了一大跳。
I used to be a cop, and I do not jump when people sneeze.
牧师以前做过警察的工作，打个喷嚏他才不会怕，但是这次他跳了吓起了。
But I did this week.
但是牧师这个礼拜真是被他吓到了。
This lady probably just had an itchy nose and maybe from allergies. But, you know, things changed these last 2 years. I can't even, you know, you can't even get sick anymore.
这个人或许只是鼻子痒打个喷嚏而已，但是因为疫情的关系，每个人都紧张兮兮的。
But here, Dr. Luke said that Peter's mother-in-law had a high fever, meaning that she was knocked down flat.Everything hurts and no way to entertain anyone.
路加福音在这里记载，彼得的岳母发热病发高烧，他躺在地上全身无力啊。
And I mean, you're so tired and you're just down. You can't cook a meal.
患着热病根本没有力气煮饭，不是吗？
Notice that they asked Jesus to help her.
但是他们却要求耶稣来帮助他。
So when you have unexpected problems, even health problems.Who do you go for help?
所以如果你发现了这个意想不到的问题的话，你会向谁求助呢？
Notice the seriousness of the fever. Jesus had to bend over and rebuke the fever, and it left her.
我们可以看到这个热病到底有多严重。耶稣必须就近他，然后弯下身子来医治他。
She was able to make a meal for them.
然后耶稣斥退那个热病，他岳母就好起来，可以来煮饭。
There is power, there is authority in Jesus' word.
So, Jesus' 的话也是带有权柄能力的。
So, what does Jesus do during his day?
所以耶稣一整天到底在干嘛？
He heals people with his word.
他用他的话语来医治人。
We need to spend time with Jesus' word.
我们需要花时间在圣经上面了。
What happened next?
接下来发生什么事呢？
Luke 4:40-41. At sunset, the people brought to Jesus.All who had various kinds of sickness, and laying his hands on each one, he healed them. Moreover, demons came out of many people, shouting, You are the Son of God. But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak, because they knew he was the Messiah.
路加福音四章四十节到四十一节，日落的时候，凡有病人的，不论害什么病，都带到耶稣那里。耶稣按手在他们个人身上医好他们。又有鬼从好些人身上出来，喊着说：“你是上帝的儿子。”耶稣斥责他们，不许他们说话，因为他们知道他是基督。
You would think that being in a synagogue, teaching Isaiah, casting demons out, healing at Simon Peter's place, one would just call it a day and just rest, especially when it's sunset.
耶稣基督在这个加百农犹太会堂 宣讲这个以赛亚的这个新闻的内容，然后呢，结束以后又医治好了这个西门岳母的热病，这一天应该结束了嘛？
But Jesus' loving kindness is for all people.
但是耶稣对每个人都充满了爱与怜悯。His
mercy is for people who come to Him.
凡是来到他面前的，他就充满怜悯的心。He
came to help people in need even after a long tiring day.
在一个一整天这样漫长的这些服事下来，他已经非常非常的疲倦，但是因为爱人们的心，他又继续服事。And
notice again, the demons knew that Jesus was the Messiah.
这些魔鬼知道，这个这些鬼魔知道，耶稣是弥赛亚。But
Jesus would not allow them to speak.
但耶稣不许他们说出来。God
has a sovereign plan for life. It's His plan. It's His timing.
神在每个人的生命当中都有他的主权，有他的计划，在他的时间点要展现出来。So
what does Jesus do throughout the day?
所以耶稣一整天到底干嘛？
He loves people who knows they are in need, even when it gets very late.
当然。 日落的时候已经非常非常晚，但他知道人们的需求，他还是满足他们。Jesus
loves.
耶稣爱啊。
Luke 4:42-44. At daybreak, Jesus went out to a solitary place. The people were looking for him, and when they came to where he was, they tried to keep him from leaving them. Verse 43. But he said, I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God to other towns also, because that's why I was sent. And he kept on preaching in the synagogues of Judea.
路加福音4:42-44，天亮的时候，耶稣出来走到旷野地方，众人去找他，到了他那里，要留住他，不要他离开他们。但耶稣对他们说：“我也必须在别城传上帝国的福音，因我奉差原是为此。”于是耶稣在加利利的各会堂传道。
So Jesus went away in the morning to a place all by himself. And from the other Gospels, we know that Jesus would spend time with his Heavenly Father in prayer.
所以一清早天刚亮的时候，耶稣基督就一个人来到他独自所处在的一个旷野里面。那在别的圣经里面，我们看到耶稣其实在那边向天父上帝祷告。So
Jesus, the Son of God, while he was here on earth, was fully God and fully man. How that works, God knows.
耶稣基督降生为人，当他在世上33年半的时候，他是完全的人，也是完全的神。这完全的人跟完全的神如何呢？我们不晓得。In
Jesus' humanity, it was important for him to spend time with his Heavenly Father, to commune with his Heavenly Father.
当耶稣他是完全的人的时候，他需要跟天父上帝祷告，需要来到上帝的面前。So
do you spend time with your Heavenly Father in the morning to start your day?
所以当我们一天刚开始的时候，我们有来到天父上帝的面前吗？
Spending time with our Heavenly Father at the beginning of the day will start our day right.
如果我们在一天的一开始的时候就来到天父上帝的面前的话，我们这一整天就是走对了。If
you are feeling dry, you and I need to go to the living water of Jesus.
当我们的生命觉得干渴的时候，我们就需要来到主耶稣基督这位生命活水的面前。If
you are feeling joyless, we need to, in the morning, start our day to go to the Word of God, to Jesus, who is the giver of joy.
当我们心中缺少那个喜乐的时候，我们也需要来到这个喜乐的泉源耶稣基督的面前。If
you are lost in life, go to the one who knows the way and can guide your path.
当我迷失生命方向的时候，我们就来到这位知道生命，因为生命的道路掌握在他手里了。Everyone
was looking for him and trying to find him, and he said, I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God to others because that's why he came.
每个人都去找他，但是他对他们说，我也必须到别的地方传上帝国的福音，因为我来是为此啊。God
has His plan to reach this world. Because Jesus preached and he went to the different towns throughout Judea sharing the good news. And people, because of that, people from all different generations, including us today on January 23, 2022, we get to hear the good news of God because Jesus went to different places to share the good news.
因为耶稣基督走向犹太各个地方来传讲上帝的道，所以直到今天，我们此时此刻，我们也能够聆听上帝国的道理。
You know, he came to be our substitute. He paid for our sins so you and I don't have to.
耶稣基督为我们的罪成为替赎，这因此他上了十字架，我们就不用再为我们的罪付上。
I mean, the question is, do you know him as your Lord, as your Savior?
我们有把主耶稣基督当我们的救主跟生命的主吗？
If not, open up your heart, allow him to come in to be your Savior and Lord.And allow him to transform your heart.
何不敞开我们的心门，迎接这位救主跟生命的主，让他来转变我们的生命。
If you do know the Lord today, spend time with the Lord this week, and allow him to have his Holy Spirit fill you, and heal you, and just give you that guidance that you need throughout life.
如果你已经认识耶稣基督成为你的主，何不这个礼拜就花时间让圣灵进入到我们的身里面，来转化我们，来引导我们呢？
Do you know Jesus' word has power and has authority?
你知道耶稣基督的话语是带有能力跟权柄的。
I mean, are you spending, you know, I keep thinking about this. God's word can heal. God's word can comfort. Are you spending time with his word regularly?To allow His Word to do that,
你知道吗？上帝的话语可以有医治跟安慰的能力呀、啊。让我们花时间在上面吧。
And if you're lacking peace today, if you're looking for that peace that you can't find anywhere, go to Jesus.
如果你已经失去平安，你在寻找那个平安的话，来到耶稣的跟前吧。
Actively listen to His word.
让我们专心专注地聆听他要对我们讲什么。
Let's pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父，
Will you help us to actively listen to your word?
主要帮助我们敞开我们的心眼心门来聆听你的话语。
Help us to realize that your word will endure forever.
主要让我们知道你的话语能够永远地存在我们的心里，发挥那个力量。
Heaven and earth will pass away, but not your word.
我们知道天地会废去，但你的话语永远长存。
I pray that your word will heal, will comfort, and give peace to each one here.
主啊，我为着在场的每一位弟兄姐妹来祷告，让你的话语能够医治安慰他们。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
祷告奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Amen. Amen.